guys, welcome to another episode of Brokerista Life. I'm Miranda, the Brokerista. Today I'm going to be teaching y'all how to make drip coffee. Drip coffee is just what pretty much everybody thinks of whenever they say that they're making coffee at home through a little coffee pot. So we're going to be learning how to do that in an AeroPress today. AeroPress can do so many different things. Espresso is just my favorite, but there's a lot, so let's teach you other things. So we're gonna start with 17 grams of espresso beans. I have my grinder. This is the Barista Encore. It's set to 18. It's a medium grind. If you have a different espresso coffee grinder, you're gonna have to play with your settings to figure out what's best for your grinder, but it's gonna be medium. Fairly coarse, you know. So 17 grams. We got 16. 17. There we go. Championships for AeroPress. It's the one that stands to do the best winning wise, so that's what I like to go with. Right. So you're going to want to put upside down, straight. Don't push it down too far because then you don't have room for all your beans and water, but you want to make sure that it's definitely sealed and everything, because otherwise you're going to have a boiling water mess. It's not fun. I've done it. Not fun. So take your grinds. Water boiling. We're gonna put our grinds in here. Alright. Just smoothing them out. Make sure that you don't make a seal break or anything when you do. So we're going to pour, once our water reaches 93 degrees centigrade, then we're going to pour 240 grams of water into here. Make sure you have enough room for everything, like I said. You don't want it to overflow or anything like that. So we're going to pour 240. We're going to stir it, and then we're going to let it sit for a minute, cap it off. You want to put a filter in the bottom, which is now going to be your little cap on top. We'll let it sit for a minute, and then we're going to brew it. We're going to press it down and flip it. So, tear this off. Barely all fits. You gotta be careful. Make sure that all of your grinds are submerged, everything's mixed up. So so that way you get as much delicious coffee flavor as possible. I have a beautiful little crema on those nice oils coming up. So, gotta twist it to lock it into place. Off of my scale. Alright. And we're just gonna wait a minute for this to sit. And then I'm gonna brew it. And flip it over. You have to work on your technique. Flipping it, it's honestly just trial and error. I find just commit, do it fast, and pray. But if you do it quickly and you're not, if you go slow, then it's gonna spill out. But if you do it fast, you're committed to it, it should be fine. Just work on it. You'll get it. Normally I would be using a timer, but I don't have one right now because my phone is filming, so I'm using my stove clock. And that's been a minute. Flip quickly. Just two drops. Pretty much made it. This recipe makes one cup seisho. Careful not to drip it on you. So with that, what we're gonna make, you can drink this just like this, black, you can add cream, sugar, whatever. Popular thing that people order in a coffee shop is cafe au lait, which just is French for coffee with milk. I'm gonna show y'all how to do that. It's simple. It's just steamed milk, so I'm gonna use my little milk steamer frother. Again, we're using just a little stir. This foams, this does not. We use this one because you don't want foamed milk for this. Let's see, put a little guy back on there. And usually cafe au lait is half and half, 8 ounces milk to 8 ounces coffee, 4 ounces, 4 ounces, however big your cup is, that's what you want to do. My cafe au lait recipe made a cup, so I'm going to do the same amount of milk. Normally, if you want a big cup, you can make a big cup. But normally, if I was making this, friends are over or whatever, and they ask for a cafe au lait, I would divide my drip recipe in half, so that way it would make one cup of a total drink. So, if you want to do that, if you're just making for yourself, you can. If you want a big cup, you can make a big cup. I'm not going to tell you no. But just make sure your proportions are right on your drip, on your milk, everything, and you'll be good to go. Let's see. There we go. Thank you. the stuff in the bottom of the cup that's not grimes, that's basically, I like to call it silt. It's just the finest possible bits of, yeah, coffee grinds, but it's more like coffee dust that falls through the filter. It's nothing to worry about. It's not gonna leave bitter taste in your mouth or anything whenever you drink it. It's okay. Good. Just wait for our milk to foam. Right. There's our milk. Nice and steamed. Big boy Chewbacca mug can hold everything. Right. So pretty. Catch a little picture for y'all after. Just pour in sweetener to taste. And a cafe au lait. I'm Miranda. This is Miss Molly, the barista buddy. See y'all next time. Thanks.